Thanks so much, David. Well, as you guys were just talking about, TikTok and its Chinese parent ByteDance said that they were shocked by this order by President Trump and said that they would be willing to take legal action, take the case to U.S. courts if they are not treated fairly. Now, Tencent, which is, of course, WeChat's owner, was a bit less aggressive in their statement, saying that it was reviewing the order to get a full understanding. Now, as you guys were discussing, for Tencent, this order looks as though it's only targeting one very small part of its business for international markets, though it's really, really important, WeChat, for the Chinese market. This is the go-to app that everybody here in China uses for their daily life. They have 1.2 billion monthly active users, and people use it to pretty much do everything. Pay for your taxi ride, for example, for your movie tickets, or to just message all of your friends. So from a business perspective, for U.S. businesses, it's also seen as essential. And that's because a lot of companies outside of the country communicate with their suppliers this way. Also, Chinese use this service in order to pay for a lot of American goods and services here in China. And then finally, a lot of U.S. companies use WeChat in order to try to reach out to new customers or to retain their customers. It's a great way to do marketing. So this is another big question that a lot of people have. But as you guys were talking about, the stock price for Tencent dramatically fell in Hong Kong. And a lot of that is because of the lack of clarity about what a transaction really is. And also here in China, people are wondering whether or not the order is only going to affect WeChat or eventually lead to a broader limitation on Tencent's business overseas.
Yeah.